I'll be showing you how to configure MikroTik 941 half light. This one, this is a 4-port router, and we are going to configure it manually. We are not going to use quick sets. So I have already reset this router, and I'll connect it to the computer, and from there we can do the configuration. So as you can see, port number 2 is blinking. I'll open Winbox on my computer. That is a MikroTik app which you can use to access your MikroTik. Right now the MikroTik does not have IP, so we'll connect to the MikroTik using the MAC address. It will just detect the MikroTik router. So I'm inside the router, and we'll start with the internet configuration so that our MikroTik can access internet. With that, okay. So in MikroTik, you will come to IP, the IP tab, I can call it that. Then you click on DHCP client. From the DHCP client, just click on add. There is a plus sign. We are going to use Ethernet 1 as our out interface. This is the interface that will connect our internet provider Ethernet cable to. So I click on DHCP. Then on that tab, there is an option for interface. So I'll choose Ethernet 1 because we are going to use DHCP to receive internet to this MikroTik. We are not using PPPoE. So after selecting that interface, just click on apply. Okay. So I have Ethernet 1. Then you go to IP. Then I'll choose addresses. Under addresses, I'll enter the IP address that I want to use for DHCP. So that's 192.168.55.1/24. Click apply. Okay. Then you go to poll. We need to create a poll. Under the poll, can give it poll name. You can just leave it poll 1. The IP address is 192.168.55.22. This is the range. 192.168.55.254. Click apply. Okay. So that is our LAN IP. And before you create this LAN IP, you also need to have the interface on which the DHCP server will be running. So we need to go to bridge. Under bridge, you create a bridge. So you click on the plus sign. You can give your bridge a name. So we'll leave it bridge 1 and click apply and OK. Then we need to add the ports that we want to run on the bridge. So we'll add port number 2. Right now I'm connected to port number 2. So let's start with 3. Port number 3. I'll add it to bridge 1. Then add another port. Port number 4. 4. I'll add it to bridge 1. I'll also add the Wi-Fi. The wireless interface to bridge 1. Once I'm done with that, then we'll go back to our addresses, then select the interface we want the DHCP server to run. Choose that, click OK. I'll enable the wireless interface and set it to AP bridge mode, apply, enable it, can give it a name and just call it tech, this is ID name, so let me call it tech. For the password, for now I don't need to give it or sign it a password because we are going to create a hotspot. I can now connect my Ethernet port with the internet provider's port number one is my one port. So I need to configure one thing, the DNS. So the DNS, I'll use Google DNS, that's 8.8.8. And click OK. So what I'll do is to ping, I want to ping Google, check whether my router has access to the internet. I'll ping 8.8.8.8, that's the Google DNS. So right now my MikroTik can connect to the internet. So we need to create another pool. Already we created a pool for our LAN interface where we'll get our IP. Those are the IPs that will be assigned to our clients. So we need to route our traffic, the LAN traffic, to Ethernet 1. So you will go to IP tab, then click on firewall. Under firewall, you'll click on the NAT tab, then we add our source address. So our source address is the LAN, the LAN IP, the one, the pool that we created for the LAN, which is 192.168.55. We'll start from 1. We can have it at 0/24. That's class C/24. That's our source address. Then the out interface is our Ethernet 1. So you want our traffic to be routed to Ethernet 1 so that you can access internet. So change that to F1, click apply, okay. So my router should be able to issue IP addresses. So you can reboot the router. Need to reboot our router, system reboot. Want to reboot, yes. So what we have so far done is to configure our F1 as our one interface. Then we created a pool for the LAN, and then we had to route the traffic from the LAN interface to F1. So there's one thing we need to do under IP firewall settings. You click on the NAT. Repeat this as a reboot. When you select your out interface, you need to change it to masquerade, so you don't want to leave it as accept. Connect. Let's wait for the connection. Refresh. So the IP connect. Under NAT, we need to change action, under action, to masquerade. Apply, okay. Then under IP, we have the DHCP server. We need the server to run on Bridge 1. So we change that to Bridge 1. And the pool, the address pool, we select the pool we created, which is pool 1. From there, now the DHCP server will be able to assign IP addresses to our clients. Under networks, you can have the IP, which is 192.168.55.0/24. You can have the gateway, 192.168.55.1, and can have these as 255.255.255.0. That is our netmask applying. So we should now receive an IP address. Need to disconnect my internet to connect to F3 because we assigned F3. F2 we did not assign it to the bridge one because we are using that internet port. As you can see now, the GCP server has issued us with an IP address. So with our port number 2, we'll now change it to the bridge, add it to the bridge 1 so that it is included under the GCP server. So you can receive an IP on port number 2. So that is it with the manual configuration for DHCP. So what we are left with is the configuration of hotspots. Thank you for watching the tutorial. Subscribe, leave a comment or message, hit the thumbs up button, and see you in the next tutorial.